हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू? आई होप यू ऑल आर वेल विथ योर फैमिली। वंस अगेन वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल रवि सर जी मैथमेटिक्स। स्टूडेंट्स, इन आर प्रीवियस वीडियो लेक्चर वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट नंबर सिस्टम। इन दैट टॉपिक वी हैव डिस्कस्ड डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ नंबर्स एज वेल एज types of decimal expansion. Students, we have discussed terminating decimal expansion, non-terminating decimal expansion, non-terminating recurring decimal expansion, and non-terminating non-recurring decimal expansion. Students, we know how to write a decimal expansion in p by q form, but we don't know how to write decimal expansion which are non-terminating recurring decimal expansion. Students, in our today's video lecture, we are going to study how to represent non-terminating recurring decimal expansion in p by q form. Let us start over here. Students, in very first question, you can see that we having 0.6 bar. It means, students, 6 is occurring again and again. It is occurring up to infinite point. So student, first of all, writing these things, considering let x is equal to 0.6666 and so on, because students, this is non-terminating recurring decimal expansion, considering this is equation 1. Students, here we have to keep in mind that we have to see that after the decimal place, how many digits occurring again and again. Students, here you can see that after decimal point, 6 is occurring infinite point. In second question, you can see that after decimal place, 2 digits are occurring again and again. After the decimal point, in third question, 3 digits are occurring again and again. So students, on the repetition of digits, we have to multiply this equation by different tens, hundreds and thousand. Students, if one digit is occurring again and again, you have to multiply that equation by 10. If two digits is multiplied again and again, you will have to multiply it by 100. If three digit is occurring again and again, you will have to multiply equation 1 by 1000. So in very first question, after the decimal place, only one digit is occurring again and again. So students, multiplying this equation by 10. So multiplying this equation by 10, so we can write what? 10x is equal to, if this numbers is to be multiplied by 10, then the decimal will be shifted over here, so you can write 6.6666 and so on. Consider this is equation number 2. Students, you want to represent this decimal expansion in p by q form, therefore equation 2 minus equation 1. Okay students, here you can see that you will have to subtract equation 1 from equation 2 to represent this decimal expansion in p by q form. So equation 2 is what? 10x is equal to 6.6666 and so on, and equation 1 is what? X is equal to 0.6666, so on. So subtracting over here, these will be cancelled out. So finally we are getting 6 and here is 9x. So students, you can write what? X is equal to 6 by 9, cancelling by 3, 2, cancelling by 3, 3. So 2 by 3 is equal to 0.6 bar. So students, you can see that 0.6 bar can be written as 2 by 3. Okay students, in second question, same process you will have to do over here. Let x is equal to 0.474747. Consider this is equation number 1. Now you can see that 2 digit is repeating after the decimal point. So equation 1 is to be multiplied by 100. So this equation should be multiplied by 100. So finally we are getting 100x. So decimal will be shifted over here, 47.474747 and so on. This is equation number 2. Now equation 2 minus equation 1. So 100x is equal to 47.474747 and equation 1 is what? X is equal to 0.474747. So subtracting equation 1 from 2, we are getting what? 47 is equal to 99x. So x is equal to 47 divided by 99. It can be written as 0.47 bar. So students, 0.47 bar can be written as 47 by 99. In question number 3, same process you will have to do over here students. So let us consider 0.143 and so on. This is equation number 1. Students, here you can see that after the decimal place, 3 digits are repeating again and again. So students, this equation will be multiplied by 1000. So multiplying this number by 1000, so decimal will be shifted after the 3 digit. So here we are getting 1000x is equal to 143.143143143 and so on. This is equation number 2. Now students, same process we will have to do equation 2 minus equation 1. So equation 2 is what? 1000x is equal to 143.143143 and so on. And equation 1 is what? X is equal to 0.143143 and so on. So equation 2 minus equation 1, here we are getting 143 and here 1000x minus x, 999x. So x is equal to 143 by 999 is equal to 0.143. So students, 0.13 bar can be written as 143 by 199. Students, you will have to practice all these things again if you want to make yourself perfect and you want to get a good marks in mathematics. Keep watching this video again and again. I will put few questions for your practice. Thank you students. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please like, share and subscribe my video once again. Thank you so much.